So it is September 22nd, 2022, and I have here, I didn't make any short grain brown rice today, and normally I would make the pasta completely separate with, just olive oil marinated throughout it, and maybe I'd dice the tomato in there first. With the tablespoon of, a teaspoon, slightly heaping teaspoon of dried oregano, usually. Or something like that. But yeah, today I made a sweet and spicy ginger, garlic, mandarin orange sauce with the extra garlic subtracted that would normally add in there. And without, let's say, a third of a small shallot, or small to medium sized shallot that I'd mince. I'd cubed up a small plum tomato in addition to simmering for a short amount of time the half a block of extra firm tofu and manually cubed in addition to a chickenless, chicken, meatless, plant-based protein substitute where I sliced the individual pieces into halves, mixed it throughout the durum meat semolina spaghetti style pasta. 40 rotations of coarsely ground black pepper. About 3 rotations of the Himalayan pink salt from the 2-inch approximately in diameter dispenser that I would normally use. So the only other thing that I had changed in this than usual would be that I cooked the noodles in while I was simmering the tofu with the meatless, plant-based, chickenless substitute with the pasta. Okay. I had sweetened it with not only, 1 tablespoon of 100% pure maple syrup. I used an additional, the usual approximate 3 level tablespoons of crystallized organic vegan cane sugar, where sometimes I do and usually would include, if I had excluded the 100% pure maple syrup, I would add in probably another 4 level tablespoons of crystallized organic vegan cane sugar to sweeten it, but it's just 3 level tablespoons tonight with the approximately 1 level tablespoon of the 100% pure maple syrup. One level tablespoon of dried powdered ginger that I would normally include in the sauce. Depends on how much or how new the dispenser for the black peppercorn would require, depending on how many rotations, the amount of rotations depends on how new or filled the dispenser would be of the black peppercorn. When it becomes lower to the base of the dispenser in quantity, the more rotations I would normally require to make that close to a level, third level teaspoon worth of it, coarsely ground. So I did about 41 rotations in there, the whole black, coarsely ground peppercorn. Anyways, it's very sweet, which is good, not too spicy. In the past, I used to include Korean red hot chili pepper flakes, like gochugaru, but I cut back on that. This would be great to, if I had also taken some of, the fresh basil leaves I have in my fridge, and as a Ziploc bag. They do mention in articles on the internet to keep it out in a, kind of like a vase, like, jar that's filled by a third to a half of, with, let's say, filtered spring water to keep it growing near a windowsill, but I store it in a Ziploc bag in my fridge in the drawer. It doesn't last as long as the other method, but what I would probably do next time, and it's still good, it's still fresh in my fridge, is that I would have taken about 3 or 4 leaves and sliced it into thin strips, the fresh basil, and mixed throughout it. I also skipped adding short grain brown rice with, you know, that cooking time. So, yeah, I wanted to kind of, like, just throw in that extra half block of extra firm tofu cubed to fill in for, let's say, not just the plant-based, meatless, chickenless chicken. Meatless substitute. It turns out really good. I did tofu last, so it's like nice and soft tonight. Lightly, marinated while the sauce was still quite hot. You know, I just put it, tossed the pasta over it, it was already in the sauce, just, so the tofu and the meatless substitute was at the bottom of the saucepan. Or, with the meatless substitute, I had actually simmered it a bit longer before including the tofu. I wanted to eat the extra firm tofu quite fresh tonight. Let's go. So it's a little, a little different tonight. You know, normally I would do it in different stages, but, and, I did top it with more vegan stinky Parmesan. I wanted to do that, that's why I wanted to make this, this one, recipe the way I had, because Wanted to try it with the stinky vegan parmesan topped over it. Which has sweet white rice flour and garlic in that already minced. They store in 2 Ziploc bags sealed in the fridge. So it's like a kind of like a quick method of assembling it. Trying to practice making the assembly process of it quicker. I did also include the sauce. About 2 level teaspoons of pure, I guess it's like toasted sesame oil. Not sure if it's toasted or not, but it doesn't taste toasted, but it looks like it's a bit darker than some other sesame oils I've had. It tastes really good, like a salad dressing almost. I did also include olive oil, the usual, about an additional 2 level tablespoons of olive oil, and I believe a teaspoon in there. 2 tablespoons and about a teaspoon level of balsamic. It's very good. So, when I was eating this, I feel like this musculoskeletal, like, tension towards the afternoon and evening hours from, like, standing while I was, like, prepping, doing the prep work. You know, I shared a little portion with some of my other family members before asking if they want a larger portion. So it takes me a little, extra time doing that. And, I'm trying to think of one side. That was, alright. This happens to me sometimes. It's like my mind goes a bit blank. I think I got a little sidetracked. This is a salad dressing. Oh, yeah. It's almost 14 minutes, and that's what probably, you know, distracted me. I have 1 minute left. Let's see, I've got 30 seconds. Oh yeah, the whole point was that it feels like I could really use a good massage, especially while eating this. Yeah, definitely. It feels good when I eat it in that type of way, because that natural anti-inflammatory properties, the ingredients. The extra magnesium from the 100% pure maple syrup got in this.